LSN Sports proudly presents the ISHL Justice Cup Playoffs. Today, it's the Justice Cup semifinals, and in semifinal round game number one, the league's top two division winners, the Cy-Woods Wildcats and the Seven Lakes Spartans. Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome inside the Sugarland Ice and Sports Center. Michael Silvers and David Feliciano on hand. It's great to have you with us. The Justice Cup semifinals begin today with a matchup of the league's two division winners during the regular season. The champions of the South, the Seven Lakes Spartans, hammered the Taylor Mustangs 7-1 yesterday in the quarterfinals up at the Willowbrook Aerodrome, thanks to a five-goal outburst by their leading scorer, senior Daniel Dufresne.
And he's been the best. Sniper, 37 goals, 46 points, has a lot of help along the way, but if you need somebody to put it in the net at crunch time, it's Dufresne.
The Cy-Woods Wildcats, champions of the North Division, took care of their business in the nightcap of the quarterfinals last night, defeating Pearland Friendswood 3-1, getting scoring contributions from Johnny Gendrell, Ryan Canty, and Jayden Munoz.
Absolutely. First time we'll see Cy-Woods this year. Their strength are their centers. Their three lines of centers, all effective scores.
It's the third meeting between the two clubs, with Seven Lakes taking the prior two in the regular season on wins of 3-1 and 4-3. So they'll meet for the third time. First half of our semifinals today. The follow-up will be at 4:15 between South Division foes Ridgepoint and Memorial West. And that'll carry us to 7 p.m. in the Justice Cup Final, where the winners will meet for the Justice Cup Championship. We're just getting started here from the Sugarland Ice and Sports Center. Up next, we'll have the scratches, the goaltending matchup, and the starting lineups, plus Dave's keys to the game. So stay with us. More to come here on LSN Sports.
Drew Doherty here, and the Texans debit card is for the ultimate Texans fans. Get your free Texans debit card when you open a Texans checking account at First Community Credit Union. Choose from three customized Texans debit cards, plus you'll have the chance to win exclusive access to Texans games, autographed merchandise, and more. Get yours today by visiting TexansChecking.com and become a member. First Community Credit Union is the official credit union of the Houston Texans. Certain criteria apply. FCCU is backed by NCUA. See rep for details.
North Shore Marine has been servicing its customers for over 40 years. Stocking one of the nation's largest parts and accessory supply, coupled with the convenience of same-day shipping, allows most boating needs to be fulfilled with one call. North Shore Marine can supply all needs from service to sales for Evinrude, Johnson, Suzuki, Yamaha, Sea-Arc, Go Devil, and parts and accessories for all your boating needs. Visit their showroom and see for yourself why North Shore Marine is one of Texas's finest Southwest dealers. Visit them on the web at NorthShoreMarine.com.
Lone Star Electric Supply is a service-oriented, Texas-based, full-line electrical distributor specializing in lighting and control design, project management, and logistical excellence. Lone Star is owned and operated by experienced leaders with a proven track record in the industry, with locations in the major hubs of Houston, Dallas, and Fort Worth. We're poised to serve electrical contractors throughout the state. Call our local office at 832-855-3400 or find us online at LoneStarElectricSupply.com. At Lone Star Electric Supply, we make it happen.
Back at the Sugarland Ice and Sports Center, Michael Silvers and David Feliciano. Scratches for today's game. For Cy-Woods, scratch Tristan Hickman from your lineup. He's a sophomore under head coach Ian Kellogg-Clark. Meanwhile, Paul Connolly will scratch the Zhang brothers, Rick Zhang and Jack Zhang, along with Brooke Deneen, as they are out in Dallas and would be available should Seven Lakes advance to the Justice Cup Final at 7 p.m. tonight. Starting goaltenders for Cy-Woods, the fifth best goaltender in the ISHL this season, sophomore Alex Opalich, has a 2.17 goals against average, saving over 90% of the shots he has faced this season. Opposite Kalen McDonald, the league's best goaltender in the regular season, the junior, with a 1.04 goals against average. Starting lineups are brought to you by North Shore Marine. For Ian Kellogg-Clark, at center, Cole Gerletti. He'll be flanked by Connor Currier and Ryan Kaufman. On defense, Ryan Canty and Carson Fenwick. Meanwhile, for Seven Lakes, starting at center, Daniel Dufresne. The wingers are Jacob Galicia and Zach Campbell. On the blue line, Cameron Saunders and Elmeri Capio. Time now for David Feliciano's Keys to the Game, brought to you by First Community Credit Union. Think first.
Well, both teams have a lot of firepower. I don't think goal scoring is going to be a problem. The key is going to be defense and goalie. Seven Lakes, best defense in the league. They're going to miss the Johns, though. That could be an issue. The goaltending is excellent. They have a lot of help from their defense. I think if the defense holds up for one of these squads, it's going to win. On paper, Seven Lakes looks like the better team, but I think this could go down to the wire, maybe overtime.
Coming up next, the opening face-off of this Justice Cup semifinals. Seven Lakes and Cy-Woods next on LSN Sports.
We've got the power to make things right.
Looking for electrical help you can count on? Switch to Mr. Electric. We have some of the best trained electricians in the business, and they're ready to help you with any project, big or small. Best of all, with Mr. Electric, our work is 100% guaranteed. That's why so many people trust Mr. Electric.
We've got the power to make things better. Mr. Electric.
Our pride is strong. Our roots are deep. Our pledge to help Houston businesses thrive is never ending. So it's no surprise Allegiance Bank is Houston's largest community bank. In fact, community is what Allegiance is all about. We believe investing back into our city, providing extraordinary personalized service, exceptional products, and even no-cost online banking and refunded ATM fees help keep Houston's economy humming. We are Houston's bank. We are Allegiance Bank. Member FDIC, Equal Opportunity Lender.
Our officiating crew for today's Justice Cup semifinal. It's a two-referee setup, two linesmen setup. What is this, the NHL?
Well, this is big time now. We got all kinds of zebras out here today.
The referees are Steven Schäuber and George Lahockey. Working the line, Sterling Kellogg-Clark and Andrew McCray. Fortunately, although the officiating assignments were issued prior to the semifinals getting all worked out with the tournament, Sterling Kellogg-Clark is obviously the son of Cy-Woods head coach Ian Kellogg-Clark, but he's not calling penalties today, so that's good.
Interesting. It's the first time we've seen Schäuber this year, I think. Good to see him again.
Indeed. Seven Lakes, the home team, in their dark uniforms, the dark blue trimmed in orange and white. Cy-Woods in white trimmed in dark red and gold. Spartans won both meetings in the regular season, defeating the Wildcats 3-1 on November 16th, and then again on March 8th, a 4-3 victory. Spartans limited the Wildcats to just 19 shots on goal in those two games, while putting up a total of 62 on Wildcat goaltender Alex Opalich.
Yeah, these goaltenders, Opalich 2.17. Kalen McDonald, 1.04. They don't give up a lot. We'll have the national anthem.
Great crowd on hand at the Sugarland Ice and Sports Center. Cameron Heiser is currently in the Seven Lakes penalty box, carryover from yesterday when he picked up a game misconduct in the third after a head check. That was a chippy game between Seven Lakes and Taylor in the quarterfinals. Three misconducts were called, two on Taylor's Patrick Miller and Noah Hopp, and the one on Heiser, which he's currently going to have to serve the remainder of before he is able to see time in this semifinal. Seven Lakes will move from left to right. Cy-Woods from right to left. So McDonald to our left, Opalich to our right. Steven Schäuber will drop the puck to get this first semifinal underway. Dufresne and Gerletti. Cy-Woods had seven skaters in the top 25 in scoring this season. Dufresne and Campbell, the only two for Seven Lakes, the top heavy scoring team. As this puck is dropped, we are underway. Puck is in the Seven Lakes zone, retrieved and spun up the boards. An outlet to Dufresne, off his stick, the turnover, a slap shot, save McDonald, or maybe that was blocked in front by Calpio as he stopped the shot that came from the 20th best goal scorer in the league, freshman Ryan Kaufman. Puck is in the slot, a backhander by Gerletti is wide. Kaufman gets the puck and brings it back to the point for Ryan Canty to try to throw towards goal. It is intercepted. Ahead now Dufresne, skates from left to right. Skates in on Opalich with a backhand centering pass, and it got caught in traffic. Work to the far boards. Spun back Calpio, shoots, and that one directed just wide by Galicia. Dufresne in deep, turned over. Swung around the far boards to Gerletti, who spins it ahead for the carry on by Connor Currier. It's a two on one. Snapshot and a shoulder save made by McDonald. Puck to the neutral zone. Dufresne lost it to Gerletti. Cross ice feed, and no one was home in the turnover. As John Wright has it, watched by number 17, Tyler Canty. Lost it behind the net. Tyler Canty, good work on the forecheck, but Seven Lakes able to get the puck back out to the center zone, and it's touched up for an offside by Munoz.
And first mistake of the night for Seven Lakes. Got a little lost on defense. It was a two-on-one and a big save by McDonald to save the day.
Cy-Woods, a 3-1 victory last night over PFC. Gendrol, Ryan Canty, Jayden Munoz with the goals. Carson Finwook took the game's only penalty for interference. And Opalich stopped 19 of 20. Puck at center ice. Kaufman got it into the zone before it was shot back out and it left defense. It is the aforementioned Carson Finwick. Off the glass, kept alive by Wright. Backhand to just wide of Opalich. Attempted clear, kept alive by Seven Lakes. Christian Beloy battles in the corner. Work to the far corner. Make it the near corner with Ethan Kamen. Swung behind the net. Down in front, Beloy is stopped by Opalich. With a minute, 1 second gone by here in this Justice Cup semifinal, the first of our day here at Sugarland Ice and Sports Center.
Another line change and first offensive opportunity for Seven Lakes. Beloy placing himself right at the goalpost and almost got a slam dunk, but a big save by Opalich.
Face off to the right of Opalich, and Dufresne lost it. Seven Lakes with a 7-1 victory over Taylor yesterday. Dufresne had five goals. Campbell, Heiser, Smith, Wright all had two assists. McDonald and Zanuto, his backup goaltender, each had time. Zanuto gave up the only goal to Patrick Miller of Taylor. Burrowing back in, Gerletti. Back to Ryan Kaufman, in deep for Gerletti behind the net. He takes a shot. They still battle behind the net, Gerletti. Kaufman looking for perhaps a feed back to the point. He finds Pede. Pede with a shot that is blocked and swept behind the net. Calpio is there. Lost it to Kaufman. Kaufman skates in the right wing corner. Puts on the brakes. In down low, Gerletti with a backhand centering pass. They got caught. He was looking for Currier, parked at the top of the crease. Slap shot from the right point is blocked and kicked to the near boards. Kept alive by Pede and shuttled in deep past Calpio. Back to get it is Zach Campbell. Swings it back to the near corner. Calpio out of his reach, Gerletti. Backhands it on the cycle. To the far boards it is Campbell, deep in his own end. They can't clear the puck, kept alive. KO on a big shot right into the breadbasket. Connor Currier, 21st in the league in goal scored, the junior stopped by McDonald.
Seven Lakes having some trouble on defense. Cy-Woods has had a lot of opportunities to set up from behind the net, very dangerous for a defense, and they've had a couple shots.
Face off to the left of McDonald. One-timer was softly, maybe got a bit of a deflection. The shot came from Jindraw, and McDonald made a glove stop.
Woods looks very strong so far. Big pressure.
Here's another slap shot that goes over the head of McDonald. Came from the right point. The outlet from left to right now. Kamen will burrow in across the offensive line. Puts on his brakes, and he loses his footing down at the half wall. Cross-ice pass brought back from Beloy to right. Swung in deep. Kamen pushed off the play by Carson Fenwick. Puck is loose. Comes back up top for House. House plays it to the far boards, and it's intercepted. And here comes Cy-Woods. Big drive. Jindraw saves. A rocket of a shot from Johnny Jindraw. And puck is loose in front again, and McDonald can't find it to the near boards. Tyler Canty will play it back to the point for Carson Fenwick with a wrist shot that's blocked, and it bounces out to the neutral zone. 8:45 remaining, first period, no score. Seven Lakes won both meetings in the regular season. Connor Smith has 2 goals against the Wildcats for the Spartans, while Connor Currier has a couple of goals for the Wildcats against Seven Lakes. Munoz, far boards, backhands it into the Spartan zone. John right at right defense, ahead for the aforementioned Connor Smith. Cuts to his right and across the line. Smith to the right wing circle, and he is taken off the play by Carson Fenwick. Fenwick looking for a lead pass, and he feeds Ryan Kaufman, the freshman, over the blue line right wing side. Snaps the shot off the catching glove of McDonald. A rebound by Kaufman, he'll get it in the corner. Pushed into the boards by Zach Campbell. Campbell leads Seven Lakes with 76 penalty minutes. Also has 25 assists. Here's Dufresne skating in. And Opalich makes a save with the left pad at point blank range right at the near post. Dufresne had 5 goals yesterday in the win over Taylor. In fact, him and Campbell have half the team's goals with 52 combined of the 104 Spartan goals this season. Dufresne in the high slot, ladled it back for Saunders at the right point. Swings it in down low. Pass Campbell. Pede will get their first far boards right in front of his bench. It's 7:15 to play, first period. Pede, number 15 for the Wildcats, almost put it between the legs of Saunders, but Saunders got a skate on it. Centering pass out of the reach of Currier. Back to the neutral zone, Gerletti possesses for the Wildcats and wedges it in. Calpio comes near side. Here's Cameron Heiser out of the box after that misconduct carryover from yesterday's quarterfinal win over Taylor. Dufresne gains the line, right wing side. In the corner, dangles. Working against Pede. Backhander in front, intercepted by Gerletti. He skates from right to left, loses his skates, falls down, gets back up. In across the line, onside is Currier. Left wing circle, shot, he scores!
They were almost offsides, and Gerletti got back on just in time, allowing his teammate to take it in, and that was almost a one-on-two for the goal scorer. That very good play by Currier, the right wing or the left wing.
Currier's first goal of the playoffs, had 13 goals in 18 games in the regular season, 1-0 Wildcats. Time of the goal, 6:26 of period number one. Here's an interception and almost another point-blank goal against Seven Lakes as Currier was robbed by McDonald after Currier with the takeaway. Up the boards, not out, kept alive by Gerletti, and Beloy goes down as Gerletti lifted him off the ice. Gerletti, right wing circle, snaps a shot wide. Ricochets to the blue line, and out Kamen will drive in before he is cut off by Brandon Kaufman. Here's Carson Fenwick striding from right to left and across the line. Gerletti parked in the slot and pass is intercepted by Saunders. Looking for a head man. And he couldn't get it to Beloy. Failed off his stick. Here's Gerletti from behind. Saunders working against him, pushing him up against the board. It is kicked back to Munoz. Down in the corner for Gerletti. Watched by Saunders. Saunders with a shoulder into Gerletti. Now Dufresne on the back check. Swings it up the near boards, out of the reach of Smith, but he's able to poke it to the line, but it's kept alive by Canty. Saunders hit from behind. Looks to retaliate as he was hit by Kevin Ford, sophomore, getting the shift here in the first period. Out to center ice, Seven Lakes with Dufresne on the puck. Gains the zone. He strides in against Peach. Shoots, save, rebound, they score! Dufresne, we're tied at one.
Just a matter of time before Dufresne got loose. It was a 3-on-2. Dufresne was on the right, took the puck. It was a rebound shot. Initial one blocked, stayed with it. Cy-Woods is out playing Seven Lakes, Mike, but with Dufresne out there, it's almost an even game.
Game-tying goal at 7:58 of the first period. Dufresne's sixth goal of the playoffs. He had 37 goals in the regular season, fourth in the league in scoring. These are the two top scoring teams in the ISHL this season. Centering pass. And Campbell couldn't connect. Here's a shot from the top of the right wing circle. Right, saved by Opalich. Gave up a rebound. Right is denied by Opalich. And the Wildcats able to clear the zone with a lead to Munoz. Has trouble with it at the blue line. House pushes up against the board. In strides Johnny Gendrol. And the defense a little too much. There was a 1-on-3 scenario there for Gendrol. Numbers game. This is disadvantage. Now Heiser for Seven Lakes. Up the boards out to the center zone. Slap back in by Munoz. Seven Lakes in control in their own end. Played up the boards and out to center. Back into the Wildcat zone. It'll be taken on at left defense by Brandon Kaufman. To center ice, Munoz ahead for Gendrol. Poked out by John Wright. Then the puck comes back in across the Seven Lakes blue line. The Wildcats are offside with 4:03 to play in the first period.
And the hitting is starting to come up as well. No penalties so far. These teams are so good skill-wise, they don't have to rely on hitting as much.
Cy-Woods, the league's top scoring team with 110 goals in the regular season. Right behind them, six goals less with 104, Seven Lakes. Seven Lakes allowed the least amount of goals this season, only allowing 23. Cy-Woods fourth in the league, allowing 52 goals. Regular season. Ryan Kaufman in across the line. Sends back to Foster. Foster pokes it into the corner for Ryan Kaufman. Strides along the goal line, roofs a shot right over the crossbar. Spun in deep by Brandon Kaufman and turned over to Mallory Calpio. Calpio has it on the forecheck by Zach Foster. Puck worked free up the near boards. Dufresne motors it out the center. Ford is backhanded to the red line. Now Smith will stride into the zone. Smith on the forehand, drops it back for Beloy. Snaps a shot, Opalich with the save. Rebound at the side of the net. Will be sent up the far boards. Laid out to center by David Thor for Cy-Woods. And he ices the puck with 2:59 to go here in the first period, a 1-1 game.
Breakneck pace, shots. Cy-Woods 7, Seven Lakes 6. Cy-Woods was up by a big margin in shots, and Seven Lakes starting to find their way a little bit.
Winner of this one will meet the winner of our next semifinal coming up at 4:15. Ridge Point and Memorial West. Ridge Point victorious over Klein yesterday, while Memorial West shut out the Woodlands in the quarterfinals 2-0. Back comes Cy-Woods. Currier, the goal scorer, from right to left and across the offensive line. He shoots just wide to the left of McDonald. Puck in the corner. Work free by Cy-Woods. Gerletti. Shot hit the side of the net. Spun behind the net. Kept alive. Centering pass from behind the goal line is intercepted. And here comes Campbell from left to right. Poked away from him by Currier. And Cy-Woods will get it back. And control behind their own net. Ryan Canty on the puck, then it's taken away. Back, John Wright, a shot wide of Opalich. Now Seven Lakes controlling in the Cy-Woods end. Spun back to the left point, John Wright has it. They'll shuttle it in deep. Below the goal line, Campbell looking for a pass into the slot. We'll have to work it back out to the point. John Wright fires a shot, and that is punched away by Opalik, jumping to the screen behind him. Less than 2 minutes to go here in the first period, 1-1 game.
Without the Johns out there, John and Saunders are going to get a lot of ice time tonight. And that almost felt like a power play for Seven Lakes. Nice offensive shift, got a good shot out of it.
Dufresne out to take the faceoff. He wins it. And the back pass out of the reach of the defenseman. Lynch had trouble with it. Ford, soft shot, well wide of McDonald. And the turnover in the defensive zone. Seven Lakes cleared all the way down. No icing is called, as officials say Brandon Coffin had a chance to play that puck at center. Far boards. Jindrall clears it. Lynch, right defense, House. 1:20 to go in a 1-1 matchup thus far in this first semifinal. Brandon Coffin cancels out Beloy in the corner. Puck comes to Jayden Munoz, and the sophomore charges into the offensive zone. Work to the near boards, and a soft backhander from the half wall, easily covered up by Kalen McDonald with 62 seconds remaining in the first period. Seven Lakes 1, Cy-Woods 1.
Well, Seven Lakes, the last few minutes really starting to equal the play. Cy-Woods came out gangbusters and dominated things about the first 5 minutes, but since then, Spartans nice and smooth, and I think Cy-Woods maybe a little tired after those first few shifts.
Gerletti, Campbell for the draw to the right of McDonald with 62 seconds to play in the first period. It's a win for Campbell. Saunders has trouble dealing with it in the corner. Hassled by Ryan Coffman. Gerletti behind the net. 54 seconds to go. Gerletti, Coffman to the slot for a shot. Currier stopped by McDonald. Oh, that was a great play. And McDonald the better of the two as the puck came free to Currier. And the better save made by McDonald. Now Kamen, who had the game winner in the second regular season meeting back on March 8th with the teams tied at 3. He scored a shorty to give the Spartans a 4-3 win. 25 seconds to go. Gerletti at the blue line. Tries to locate Currier. Good defense by Seven Lakes by Saunders, but he almost turned the puck over in his own end. Eventually turns it over in the neutral zone. Last 13 seconds of the first period. As the Wildcats shoot in. Near boards, Heiser. Couldn't clear the zone, Gerletti kept it in, but that will do it for period number one. What an excellent first period. Each team with the goal will be back to start the second in just a moment here on LSN Sports.
North Shore Marine has been servicing its customers for over 40 years, stocking one of the nation's largest parts and accessory supply, coupled with the convenience of same-day shipping, allows most boating needs to be fulfilled with one call. North Shore Marine can supply all needs from service to sales for Evinrude, Johnson, Suzuki, Yamaha, Sea-Arc, Go Devil, and parts and accessories for all your boating needs. Visit their showroom and see for yourself why North Shore Marine is one of Texas's finest Southwest dealers. Visit them on the web at northshoremarine.com.
Drew Doherty here. And the Texans debit card is for the ultimate Texans fans. Get your free Texans debit card when you open a Texans checking account at First Community Credit Union. Choose from 3 customized Texans debit cards, plus you'll have the chance to win exclusive access to Texans games, autographed merchandise, and more. Get yours today by visiting texanschecking.com and become a member. First Community Credit Union is the official credit union of the Houston Texans. Certain criteria apply. FCCU is backed by NCUA. See rep for details.
Back at the Sugarland Ice and Sports Center, 1-1, Cy-Woods and Seven Lakes after the first period of this Justice Cup semifinal.
Unofficial stats, shots, Cy-Woods 9, Seven Lakes 6. Again, we have a couple of great goaltenders. A lot of shots to start off this game. The offense is... both these offenses, they don't really take the night off. I mean, they're going to put 30 on you, no doubt.
Opalik to our left, McDonald to our right. Currier scored at 6:26 for Cy-Woods. And at 7:58, Daniel Dufresne tied it. Puck in the Spartan zone. Near boards, Ethan Kamen. Work back to John Wright. Accidentally cut And a save by McDonald on Gerletti, but the pass that was worked around the boards behind the goal accidentally went off the skate of referee Steven Schäuber, and it led to a great chance for Cy-Woods.
Extra pair of zebras out there tonight. We got four.
Cy-Woods wins the offensive zone draw. Puck worked behind the net. Gerletti lost it. The far boards went through the legs of Heiser, kept alive by the Wildcats. Right, far boards. Carson Fenwick stops it at left defense before the puck goes off of his stick and Cameron Heiser's stick and into the Cy-Woods bench.
The one good thing about these squads is we've seen this season a lot of the teams have trouble manning enough for three lines, but we have plenty of players on both sides tonight, so they can go very deep and fatigue won't be as bad.
Face off just outside of the Spartan zone. Gerletti and Campbell. Gerletti wins it. Fenwick in left defense. Turned over to Saunders. Make it Connor Smith, and he will shoot it in. Beloy behind the net for Smith. Try to get it back to Campbell. His centering pass is picked off. Back from left to right, Connor Currier, the junior, and across the blue line. Strides to the slot, drops it for a slap shot by Gerletti. A stick failed him. Lead pass off the backside of Zach Campbell. Work to the right wing for Connor Smith, and he lifts it in on a cross-corner dump-in. Campbell behind the net, watched by Brandon Kaufman. Kaufman picked his pocket, got it back. Worked up the near boards, kept alive, and sent down low by Calpio. Gerletti walks it out of the zone, cuts to his left, gains the Spartan zone, puts on the brakes and pivots, looks for a centering pass. Fenwick took it away from Smith. Here's Gerletti, a shot saved out of his crease, McDonald, as he lost track of the rebound. Fenwick backhands it in deep. Calpio bangs it off the boards, onto the tape of Campbell. Campbell cutting to his left and across the line. Nice move on the backhand of Pollich with a glove save.
Campbell's an assist man, but watch out. He can score as well. And made a nice move to his left, and as Mike said, the backhand. Pollich was ready, didn't get fooled.
Minute 48 gone by here in the second period. Teams tied at one. Campbell goes to the box. He's been called.
Huh. He was the puck man. Interesting. Unless he shot a defender on the way up.
Didn't catch the penalty, but it's a Mr. Electric power play for a very robust power play. Cy-Woods, 20 power play goals the regular season. Mr. Electric, we have the power to make things better. Dufresne on the shorthand. He shoots one all the way through the crease. Slap wide of the net by Kamen. Seven Lakes had three shorties this season. Took 216 minutes of penalties. Here's Munoz to Canty. Cy-Woods trying to get things set up. Tyler Canty back to P. Shoots from the left point. Block. Rebound came out to Canty, and his shot was stopped by McDonald. P walks in, top of the left wing circle. His slap shot is blocked. Opportunity on the shorthand. Canty is back, and a shot softly paddled away by Opalich. The shorthanded bid by Sean John Wright. 56 seconds to go on the penalty to Campbell. Campbell with 76 penalty minutes, which was the most picked up by any Spartan this season. Seven Lakes clear it down. Ryan Canty, team leader in assists to Johnny Gendrol, who walks in. Drop pass, the shot was blocked by Calpio. And he backhands it clear, just to the neutral zone. Kaufman sends back towards the blue line. And across the blue line, Munoz locates Canty. Canty, a wrist shot, glove save, McDonald, with 19 seconds to go on the Campbell penalty.
Kind of an uninteresting power play for Cy-Woods, not very effective, and they finally get a look about 20 seconds left. Good job by Seven Lakes to kill most of that. And they had a couple opportunities shorthanded.
19 seconds to go on the penalty. 9:31 for the second period. It's a 1-1 game. Currier will take the faceoff. Gerletti couldn't get the shot off. It went right to his stick. Kaufman down low with 10. Gerletti puts a Spartan on his seat, and that was Cameron Saunders. Gerletti near the goal line, shoots from a tough angle. That went through the crease. Back to Fenwick. Penalty time is up. Campbell's out of the box. He's stationed at the blue line right in front of the Cy-Woods zone. A shot by Kaufman. About 6 feet out. Stopped by McDonald as Ryan Kaufman has 10 goals this season. Looking for his 11th. Couldn't get the job done.
Cy-Woods still putting pressure on shot-wise. 14-8.
9:04 remaining in the second period. Face off to the right of McDonald. Dufresne and Gerletti for the draw. Don't forget, second semifinal at 4:15. Memorial West and Ridge Point. They played each other three times in the regular season. Memorial West won the first matchup. Ridge Point took the next two. Now Dufresne is kicked out. Here's Fenwick with a check. That was a shot that was blocked. Currier took it. And the Spartans skated out with Dufresne, striding along the left wing boards. Dufresne, good defense by Brandon Kaufman, forced it below the goal line. Back come the Wildcats. Gerletti got the lead from Currier and walks it across the blue line. Currier tries a backhander, and Ryan Kaufman couldn't get to it. Seven Lakes send it all the way down, and icing is whistled on the Spartans. 4 minutes, 26 seconds gone by. Period number two, 1-1.
They're still getting the numbers, Cy-Woods. They're getting over there 3-on-2. They always have a man advantage, it seems like, so doing a good job. And Seven Lakes really needs to rally. They can't do it alone if just Dufresne.
Campbell and Munoz for the faceoff. Puck is dropped to the right of Campbell. McDonald. Shot from Pede from the left point is blocked. 3-on-2 developing the other way for the Spartans. Kamen. His centering pass picked off by Gendron. His lead is too far out in front of Munoz. Taken back the other way by House. Goes across ice feed. And it is lifted in by Ethan Kamen, a sophomore for Seven Lakes. Campbell, near boards, tried to get it to the right point. It was picked off there. And Pede swinging around his own net, far boards. Tyler Canty couldn't play it. Back for a shot, sticked away by Opalich. House in down low. Campbell is there. Campbell back to the point for House. House fires a shot, glove save. Opalich, no rebound.
That's okay. If your front line guys aren't getting it done, the defenders can put some pressure on. Maybe you can get a rebound.
7:44 left in the second period. Face off to the right of Opalich. Back to the point. Saunders down into the corner. Beloy, centering pass, and ooh, that one just caught in traffic. Dufresne was at the top of the crease. Back to Saunders, left point. Half wall, Dufresne snaps a shot, glove save, like a baseball catch.
Yeah.
The catching glove of Alex Opalich, the sophomore netminder for head coach Ian Kellogg Clark.
Those are not easy, coming from 40, 50 feet out. If you can get the hand up there, it's like catching a curveball. Very difficult.
Opalich will watch this faceoff come to his right. Won by Dufresne. Battle at the half wall. And Gendron skates it out from left to right. Gains the zone. Cuts to his left. Drop pass intercepted by Smith. Dufresne canceled out by Ryan Canty, who walks it across the blue line. In the center area, there's a penalty coming up.
Yeah.
As Gendron went down in the high slot.
That's probably a rough, I think it might have been Dufresne. That's who they got.
Saunders.
Yeah, he knocked him pretty good, right in the slot.
Cross check.
And I don't even think it was kind of came from behind as well. So that's two penalties on Seven Lakes.
Penalty at 6 minutes of period number two. 1-1, another Mr. Electric power play. Fenwick shoots, locked in front, the ricochet. Still puck is bouncing, it goes to the back of the net, or behind the net, to the point. Brandon Kaufman Down low. Big hit. Put on Connor Currier. Comes back to Hoffman. His shot is blocked. And sailed wide. Fenwick. Center point. Brandon Kaufman gets there. Finds Currier. Back to Kaufman. Kaufman shoots. And that was blocked and cleared by Seven Lakes. Cy-Woods taking shots, having some trouble getting it through. Here's a turnover on the shorthand. Campbell finds Kamen, shoots, save made by Okalic.
Wow. That's a textbook shorthand. Get one man down and sneak somebody else behind everybody. It was Kamen. That's from 5 feet out. What a save.
43 seconds killed by Seven Lakes. Game tied at one. 6:17 to play, period number two. Gendron and Beloy for the faceoff to the left of Opalic. Beloy controls, pushing to the boards by Fenwick. Looking to work the puck free, he's getting some help from Tyler Canty. Beloy, good job keeping it pinned to the boards and taking off precious power play time for Cy-Woods. And a big, Woo! Oh, and Smith is gonna get pinched at center ice as he took Gendron down.
That's not good for Seven Lakes. They still get another minute on that first penalty.
Steven Schäuber calls the penalty. Smith having words with Munoz. And it's going to be a 5-on-3 for Cy-Woods. And a misconduct to boot on Connor Smith.
Yeah, this is a great opportunity for Cy-Woods. Plenty of time to work with.
So you get the misconduct tacked onto the interference. 5-on-3 for a minute for the Wildcats. Penalty comes at 6:59 of the second period. Big opportunity for the Wildcats, who lost both regular season meetings to Seven Lakes this season.
4 minutes in eternity.
That's a 2 minute, yeah, so now it's even more. So you get the 2 minute misconduct tacked on. 5-on-3 for another 53 seconds. Canty, right point. That's Ryan Canty, the senior. Swings into the corner. Seven Lakes get control, but only momentarily. Comes back to P, top of the left wing circle. Blast a shot wide. Here's Currier. Back to P, left wing circle. P. Down low for Ryan Kaufman. Back to Pede. And the puck finds McDonald, and McDonald stops it. 18 seconds to go on the 5-on-3.
Pede better get ready. He's going to have a lot of shots on this shift. They seem to like his side. He's a tall player with a big shot.
5-on-3 for another 18 seconds before a 3-minute 5-on-4.
Pede goes to the bench.
5:18 left in period number two. Teams tied at one, but this is a great opportunity for the Wildcats. Carson Fenwick, right point. Wrist the shot, that was blocked. Ricocheted off of Calpio over the crossbar. Ryan Canty, right wing circle, one-timer. Courier's blocked by Calpio. Penalty time is up, and it's gonna be 5-on-4 as a sharp angle shot by Courier, saved by McDonald. So now a power play, a 5-on-4 for Cy-Woods for another 2:58 here in the second period.
Well, they survived the first minute. Extra man out there now. You just kind of form a diamond around your goaltender and just take the abuse.
Face off to the left of junior goaltender Kalen McDonald. Seven Lakes get possession, and they clear it down.
Now if they can survive this kill, that'll be a big, big step for them.
Fenwick stops behind his own net, watched by Heiser. Head up the left wing, and Gendron couldn't get it out of his own zone. Spun in deep again. Fenwick has to get it all started over again. Up the left wing for Gendron. And a big hit there on a rink-wide pass. Jayden Munoz, top of the right wing circle. His shot is blocked. 2:25 to go on the penalty. Two penalties taken by Cameron Saunders. Interference and a misconduct. Here's Canty. Shoots, blocked as they park right in front of McDonald. A clearing attempt has to be dealt with by Opalic. Just over 4 minutes to go here in the second period. 2:05 on the power play for Cy-Woods, which is brought to you by Mr. Electric. Getting to the puck first on the shorthand, Kamen, but he's canceled out by Fenwick, and a penalty is coming up on Fenwick for interference.
Well, that worked out for Seven Lakes. Kamen, a great hustle player, got in there against the larger Fenwick, and Fenwick, I think, panicked a little bit, stuck him to the boards, and now this evens things out.
First penalty called on Cy-Woods. Carson Fenwick, the junior, spent 12 minutes in the penalty box this season. Johnny Gendraw has the most power play, most penalty minutes for Cy-Woods with 40, so 4-on-4 now for another minute 50 before Saunders is sprung from the penalty box. Dufresne walks in, left circle, shot, and on the short side, again, another save made by Alex Opalich.
And now Seven Lakes can breathe a sigh of relief. They got their best scorer out there, Dufresne, and it's even strength in a sense.
And behind the goal, Kamen, working on his backhand, monitored by Pete. Pete poked it away, played behind the net. Brandon Kaufman is there, turned it over, left circle, Dufresne, shot, ricocheted right in front of the goaltender, off of Pete and into the corner. Gerletti walks the puck behind his own net, strides from left to right, and will skate out of his own end. Cut to his right, Gerletti on the 4-on-4. Got it in across the line before he's taken away off the puck. Dufresne, a lead pass, goes through the skates of Kamen down into the corner, and Pete is there for Cy-Woods. 3 minutes to go, second period. A minute to go on the Saunders two penalties. So not much of a power play will be given to Seven Lakes as a whistle halts play, and the faceoff will come all the way down into the Cy-Woods end.
I think these teams really got to try to make an effort. There's so much space on the ice. Got two less players out there. There's your best skaters have got to try to take it one-on-one.
Campbell and Gendraw. Faceoff, work back, house, tees up a shot. Paddle save made by Opalich. That shot came from the point. Now Gendraw. Here comes a 2-on-2. Munoz carries over. Got by one defender. Puck behind the net. Gendraw couldn't get to it. Up the near boards, pinching in Ryan Canty. Canty in the circle, tried to get it down low at the side of the net. Good defense, Munoz was ready for it, but the Spartan defense equal to the task. Now back into the Wildcat zone, Beloy. Directed into the corner by Pete. Beloy and Pete. Pete gets the puck. Up the far boards, he'll skate it out into the neutral zone. Shoot it in on goal. Stopped by McDonald. The far boards, Pede takes a shot at it. Blocked, Munoz, left wing circle, wrist shot, save McDonald. Penalty time is up on Smith, so 6 seconds of power play time for the Spartans with an even 2 minutes remaining here in the middle period, 1-1 between Cy-Woods and Seven Lakes, Justice Cup semifinal.
Well, all those penalties and nothing came of it. Good job by both kill units.
Face off to the right of McDonald. Saunders. Watched by Gerletti on the forecheck. Strides. Penalty time is up. Teams at even strength. 5-on-5 hockey. As Fenwick comes skating out. Wildcats have it in their own end. Handed back out to center. No. Kept alive by Saunders as he stopped Gerletti from clearing it out into the neutral zone. Here's Calpio deep in his own end. Puts on the brakes, locates Pipe. Couldn't clear the zone, but walking it out, though, is Currier. Brandon Kaufman at left defense, uses the boards. Here's Gerletti, skates in, left wing side, puts on the brakes. Tries to locate a centering pass for Currier. At the Spartans, able to clear it out to the neutral zone. In from right to left. House. Checked by Fenwick into the boards. Three Spartans trying to work that puck free. Here's Galicia, turned over at the goal line. And Gerletti kicks it out to center. Ford into the Spartan zone. The play is whistled offside.
Yeah, Currier. right at center ice by maybe two steps. It was very close.
48.9 seconds. Tightly contested Justice Cup semifinal with the winner moving on to tonight's Justice Cup final. 7 p.m. puck drop here from the Sugarland Ice and Sports Center. Faceoff win for the Spartans. Reed Condra on the ice for a shift in the second period. Dufresne has Boyce streaking to the net. Shot by the left-hander Dufresne, and Opalich makes another save. Brandon Kaufman clears the zone. Munoz has a two-on-one developing with Tyler Canty. Munoz to Canty, who shoots, and a pad save made by McDonald. Munoz into the left-wing corner. Fenwick shoots from a tough angle, and McDonald stops it with 18.2 seconds left in the second period.
What a play by McDonald. Munoz's pass, very nice, and that should have been put away, but McDonald's, he actually had to get down for that one. He saved two.
Offensive zone faceoff for Cy-Woods in the last 18.2 of the second period.
This has been a gritty period, Mike. Penalties and pretty much even play.
Munoz and Campbell. Munoz wins it. Fenwick lifts it into the right wing corner. Kamen got there first. Back to Brandon Kaufman, right point. Shot it well wide into the left wing corner. House up the far boards, has trouble possessing the puck. Work to the middle of the ice, and that does it for period number two. 1-1 after two in this Justice Cup semifinal. Back with the third and final period after this on LSN Sports.
Lone Star Electric Supply is a service-oriented, Texas-based, full-line electrical distributor specializing in lighting and control design, project management, and logistical excellence. Lone Star is owned and operated by experienced leaders with a proven track record in the industry, with locations in the major hubs of Houston, Dallas, and Fort Worth. We're poised to serve electrical contractors throughout the state. Call our local office at 832-855-3400 or find us online at LoneStarElectricSupply.com. At Lone Star Electric Supply, we make it happen.
When it comes to Houston's growth and success, Allegiance Bank means business. Just one more reason we are Houston's bank. As a small to mid-sized business owner, you need a bank dedicated to helping you with acquisition financing, expanding your operations, lines of credit, treasury services, and above all, exceeding your goals for success. From fast answers to extraordinary service, at Allegiance, we pledge to do all we can to help Houston businesses thrive. Allegiance Bank, we practice what we pledge. Member FDIC, Equal Opportunity Lender.
Periods in the books, 1-1 game. McDonald to our left, Opalich to our right for the final period of regulation.
Shots through two periods unofficially. Cy-Woods 19, Seven Lakes 14. The fans are getting into it. They know it's crunch time. 1-1.
Dufresne and Gerletti for the faceoff. Five penalties called in the second period, and yet just two even strength goals, both coming back in the first period. Currier and Dufresne. Wright shovels it in. Stopped behind the net by Opalich. He leaves it for Pede. Pede near boards, Ryan Kaufman. Rink wide pass to center. Currier walks it across the blue line. Lead pass to Letty, backhander. And a stick save made in behind the goal by McDonald. Heiser couldn't clear the zone. Ryan Kaufman finds Currier, shoots and scores from the right circle. His second of the game, 2-1 Wildcats.
Yeah, Kaufman got a loose puck, brought it in the slot. What a pass, Currier. That's real easy for Currier, just wristed it in. And look at Currier, two goals tonight.
So for the second time, Seven Lakes trail. For the second time, the Wildcats have the lead.
He's their fourth leading scorer.
Currier was held off the score sheet from a goal scoring perspective yesterday in the win over PFC, has it again. Finds Ryan Kaufman with a one-time bid that was blocked by Saunders in the corner. Campbell took the puck away. Ahead now for Beloy. Works around the right wing board, pushed from behind by Currier. The outlet to center, off the skate of Ryan Kaufman. Kaufman will drive along the right wing boards, and he will shovel it in. Calpio, from left to right. Poked away, but kept alive. Here's Gerletti with a sharp angle shot. McDonald with the stop. Far boards, Ryan Kaufman keeps it alive for the Wildcats. Looking for a centering pass. That was blocked. Bounces in the right wing circle. Another puck that was backhanded to the top of the crease and swept away by the Spartans. Minute and a half gone by, third period. Early goal here in the third has given the Wildcats a 2-1 advantage. Second goal of the afternoon for Connor Currier. Canty swipes it back into the Spartan zone. Calpio near boards at center. Connor Smith took 4 minutes worth of penalties in the second period. Smith, his centering pass, and Gendral goes down. And fans appeal for a trip. It didn't come. Pass, ooh, bounces. Pad save off that ricochet by Opalich. Now they battle behind the net. Carson Fenwick comes away with the puck for the Wildcats, and he clears to the neutral zone with 2:15 gone by in the third period. 2-1 Wildcats, winner to the Justice Cup Final tonight at 7. Seven Lakes has been to the Justice Cup Final only once before. They lost it in a shootout back in 2012. Cy-Woods have never been there. Dufresne tries to pick a corner from the right wing circle, shot it over the crossbar. Gendral out to center ice, turned over House, and it hits one of the Wildcats on the bench. 10:21 to play here in regulation, 2-1 Cy-Woods.
You can just see Dufresne, he just wants another one. He's starting to attack, and he did load up that one. Shot for the upper left corner, went way wide.
Dufresne, Gerletti at center. House slaps it in. Seven Lakes from left to right in the third period. Cy-Woods from right to left. Galicia battles with Fenwick behind the net. Fenwick gets the puck into the corner. Brandon Kaufman is there helping out from the back check. 3-on-2 battles. They work the puck along the boards. Gerletti walks it out from right to left. Cuts to his right. Back to Currier. Dufresne clears the zone. Hops over the stick of Ryan Canty. Goes all the way deep into the Wildcat end. And that puck is intercepted. Wright waits for Galicia to get onside. He spins in, shoots wide. Galicia, the half wall, left wing side. Saunders tried to work it back down low, and it's intercepted, and back comes Currier with a rink wide to Gerletti. Gerletti, top of the right wing circle, snaps a shot, easily dealt with by McDonald. With 9:22 left in period number three, 2-1 Wildcats.
Seven Lakes just needs more offense. Only 14 shots, and the last few have gone well wide. Meanwhile, Cy-Woods still pressure, now 22. They're just outplaying Seven Lakes.
Campbell and Munoz for the faceoff. Spun back to the point, Ryan Canty, left defense. Pede shoots, locked in front, kick to the near wall. Smith has Campbell in front of him in the lead to Campbell out of his reach. But Campbell will start burrowing in on the forecheck. But Pede at left defense works it out to the neutral zone. Carried in by Munoz. Munoz shoots, blocked to the half wall. He gets pushed into the boards by Saunders. Smith sees that puck go behind him, comes to the high slot. Canty's shot is deflected up into the mesh. 4:12 gone by here in period number three. 2-1 game for Cy-Woods.
Cy-Woods, they're just so good at surrounding the slot. Seven-Woods just cannot get it out. They're getting a few rushes, but really no help.
These two teams played tight games back in the regular season. Two-goal win in the first meeting for Seven Lakes. A one-goal victory in the second meeting. Back to Spartans. They come from left to right. Dufresne cuts to his left.
Yep.
And he is offside.
Heiser.
Heiser in a little early. Stops the rush. 8:33 to go.
That's surprising. Usually DeFrain's the first one in there. I was just quick, though. That was too bad. That was about a 3-on-2.
Faceoff comes outside of the Wildcat zone. Don't forget, second semifinal at 4:15, or approximately 4:15, between Memorial West and Ridge Point. The faceoff win by Seven Lakes, but it goes all the way into their own zone. Calpio in the corner, monitored by Currier. Kamen ahead for Dufresne. And Dufresne couldn't clear the zone. Kamen tries to retreat, has the puck on his stick. His outlet pass was deflected by the Wildcats. He kept alive in the Spartan zone before it was cleared, and then right back in to the Spartan zone where it is cleared again. Smith, and across the line, Dufresne. Dufresne tried to get the puck away from Kaufman. The loose puck is collared by Fenwick. Fenwick has it as an own end. Little dipsy doodle and a spinorama, and back into the Wildcat zone. It's Currier. Down low, Gerletti behind the goal line. Tries a wraparound bid. Puck is loose and steered away by Owen House. House from left to right, middle of the ice. Strides out of his own end. Crossed the red line. Good individual effort to gain the zone. Shoots, glove save of Polich. 4:35 gone by. Check it, 5:35 gone by.
Plenty
of
time.
Cy-Woods.
Still plenty of time for Seven Lakes. And again, these shots, just not a lot of mustard. Kind of up high and easy to catch for a Polich. Seven Lakes, they got to crack down a little further.
Face off to the right of a Polich. John Wright shoots, save a Polich, gave up a rebound. The puck to the left side of the crease. Work to the near boards. Back to Wright, his shot well wide. Pete in a race with Campbell. Up the boards for Munoz. Munoz along the right wing boards. He skates and lifts it into the zone where it'll bounce to McDonald, puts his glove on top of it, and gets a whistle with 7:05 remaining in the semifinal. 2-1 Cy-Woods.
Well, Seven Lakes not used to being in this situation. Again, though, plenty of time, and they still got some good snipers.
Face-off win for Cy-Woods, but Seven Lakes are able to get possession, get it out to the neutral zone. Matt Pipe walks it in. Couldn't find Campbell. Puck still in the Wildcat zone and poked out to center ice. Ahead for Canty. Ryan Canty drops it back for a shot by Jindraw. That is ricocheted wide. Munoz spins it in below the goal line. Puck to the side of the net. Now Canty walks it behind the goal. Comes out to the right wing corner. Up to the high slot, and now a turnover, and Heiser skates it on a breakaway. Cameron Heiser looking for the tie. Backhands. Save made by Opalic. The net behind Opalic comes loose as Heiser couldn't beat the sophomore goaltender. And the lead still at 1 for Cy-Woods, and a big-time save by Alex Opalic.
He's very good on the backhand. That's what Heiser went. Juke left. Opalic made the big save and actually got a little break. The goal got knocked off the stanchion and by a few minutes of rest.
Face off to the right of Opalic, Kamen and Gerletti. They cancel each other out. Puck bouncing in the circle. Lifted to the point. Calpio sends in deep to the corner. Smith will get there. And he'll be canceled out by Ryan Kaufman. Saunders kept it alive. Down low. Nope. Say it came across the blue line out to center. Seven Lakes whistle for offside. 6:11 to go in the third period. 2-1 Wildcats.
The Seven Lakes, they want to cherry pick one like that one. Heiser had that steal. If they can get a few more of those, put a little fear into Opalic, they have a shot.
Face off outside of the Cy-Woods zone. Controlled by Currier. Motoring from right to left, he shoots in. To the corner, off the boards, Kamen takes possession. On the forecheck, Currier, House, up the near boards. And again, they couldn't clear. Currier shot, blocked in front, deflected as it changed speeds, but McDonald able to make the save. 5:47 to go, 2-1 Wildcats.
Excellent play by McDonald. That one knuckled in there on the deflection, luckily right in his breadbasket. Under 6 minutes.
Dufresne, the captain, takes the faceoff to the left of his goaltender. Munoz for the Wildcats, won by Dufresne. Dufresne, the only goal scorer. Here's a weird ricochet. Puck comes to Jindra on the left circle, but he fans on the shot. Ryan Canty from a tough angle, wide of the target. Pede, softly from the left point. That shot easily blocked by Dufresne, works it behind his own net. Gives it away. Oh, the puck hopped over the stick of Munoz. Certainly would have been a giveaway. House clears the zone. Pede at right defense. 5:20 to go in regulation. 2-1 lead for the Wildcats. The turnover, but Campbell couldn't get anything going. Here's Jindraw, cutting wide to his left, poke from him. Campbell takes possession and across the line, and he is tripped up by Jindraw. It's going to be a power play with 5:04 remaining for Seven Lakes.
That's not a good time for that. That's a legitimate call. I think that's a very good call. And oh, now Seven Lakes licking their chops. They got Campbell and Heiser out there, Dufresne. They got the snipers ready to go.
Jindraw, the most penalty minutes. Cy-Woods this season, off for tripping. Mr. Electric power play for Seven Lakes. Dufresne shoots. Deflected over the crossbar. Needing a game-tying goal. Dufresne, right circle. Shot blocked into the corner. Beloy down on one knee. Trying to find Dufresne. Keeps it under, keeps it below the goal line. Puck sucked up the boards. As Pede shoulders Dufresne. Release puck in front of the goal. And Cy-Woods clear the zone. But only out to the center zone. House at left defense. 1:25 on the power play. House gains the line. Drops it back for Campbell. Takes it to the left wing circle. Skates in, shoots, saved by Opalich. Puck hit him in the chest. Gave him a rebound, but dropped on it. 45 seconds killed by the Wildcats. 4:20 left in regulation. The Wildcats clinging to a 2-1 lead.
Shots unofficially. Cy-Woods 23, Seven Lakes 18. Four apiece this period.
Face off to the right of Opalich. Won by Dufresne. House, left defense. Shoots well wide, off target. Puck comes all the way back. Right point, Saunders. Plays it off the glass. Fenwick, watched by Beloy. Fenwick gets the puck on his stick. Holds and shoots down. Nope, actually shoots it out of play. So let's see where they place the faceoff. 57 seconds remaining on the Spartan power play. Puck's going to remain in the Wildcat zone for an offensive zone faceoff.
This will be a big faceoff. Sometimes it just takes one touch and you can load up and shoot.
Frame will take the faceoff opposite Ryan Kaufman. Win again. Slap shot from the point. It was deflected into the corner as the shot came from House. Campbell, centering pass to Frame and stuffing the five hole. Was Opalich. Wildcats clear. 42 seconds remaining on the man advantage for Seven Lakes. 3:40 for this semifinal. Campbell. Heiser had a breakaway but was denied by Opalich. Here's House shooting, sticked away by Opalich. Farboards Campbell, tried to get it back to the point, but nobody was there. And Saunders has to recoil in his own end, or in center ice, as O'House is able to find Dufresne. Dufresne comes across the blue line. The play is whistled offside. 12 seconds to go on the Jindraw penalty. 3:16 for regulation. 2-1 Cy-Woods.
House made the pass, went in the zone, but Dufresne had not yet entered the zone. That's a tough break. They were trying for one more rush. Now the power play only down to 12 seconds.
Cy-Woods takes a timeout. Seven Lakes lost only one game this season. Memorial West with a 1-0 victory early on this year. And right now, Cy-Woods 3:16 away from handing Seven Lakes their second loss of the year. But even more important for Cy-Woods, the victory propels them to the Justice Cup final for the first time in club history later tonight at 7.
It would be our first upset of the playoffs, even though Cy-Woods is pretty darn good. Wouldn't be too much of an upset. But they're really outplaying Seven Lakes is having a good period nonetheless. They've had some really good looks, but Apollich coming up big this third period.
Justice Cup playoffs are a production of LSN Sports. Any rebroadcast, retransmission, or any other use of this broadcast without the express written consent of LSN Sports is strictly prohibited. Running down the scoring summary at 6:26 of period number one, Connor Currier gave Cy-Woods a 1-0 lead. Game tying goal came at 7:58 of the first as Daniel Dufresne scored even strength. Teams were scoreless in the second period. And in 38 seconds into this final period, Currier notched his second goal. And that's where we stand. 3:16 left in the third period. 12 seconds remaining on Seven Lakes' power play. Puck worked into the Wildcat zone. Smith, right circle, shot. A bouncing puck saved by Opalich. Puck is behind the net. Kamen tried a centering pass. Gerletti cleared the zone. And it sprung Ryan Kaufman, or Brandon Kaufman, I should say, before Calpio got the puck. Finds Saunders, played back behind the goal. Calpio ahead up the left wing for the poke into the neutral zone. Now it's Galloy. Kamen backhands it in. 2:40 to play in the third period. Back comes Currier, striding from right to left. Across the line, snaps a shot in the pad, saved by McDonald. Brandon Kaufman pushed into the boards. Stuck there by Cameron Saunders. Kamen helps. It's a 2-on-2 scrum in the corner. Smith comes in to help. It's a 3-on-2. And it's worked free by Smith. And a whistle.
They got tied up in the corner. Who's it on?
Looks like maybe some helmets got stuck together. The face mask.
My goodness.
Brandon Kaufman.
Hopefully they have
Ryan
fresh
Kaufman.
Breath.
And Cameron Saunders, 2:18 to play.
Yeah, this is it, Mike. Crunch time. 2 minutes.
Face off outside of the Spartan zone. Won by Dufresne. House shuttles it in. Fenwick first to the puck below the goal line. Pushed into the boards by Heiser. Cy-Woods work it out with Ryan Kaufman.
Oh!
And he shoots in. Less than 2 minutes to go. Windia decide to pull McDonald for the extra attacker. Right now, you're not going to do it with the play in the Spartan zone. Ryan Kaufman swings and misses on a shot from the high slot. Dufresne careens it off the boards behind the goal as McDonald is summoned to the bench. Right. Rink-wide pass, near side, Heiser skates in. Heiser, watched by Fenwick along the goal line. Worked behind the net, rebound, shot, save. They poke at it, no signal yet. No goal, Opalich kept it out.
A lot of traffic out front. We couldn't see if it got through, but Opalich, a lot of bodies piling on. They made the save.
6-on-5. And an offensive zone faceoff after Opalich shut the door. All started with a wraparound bid. House had a glorious chance from the right wing circle, but somehow the puck stayed out. Shot off the post from Beloy. The clear to the neutral zone. House skates it back in, shoots wide. Beloy off his stick, far boards, and it is sent all the way down. Will it reach the goal? No. Dufresne got there with his speed. Gendral couldn't keep it alive at the point. Lifted towards the blue line. Beloy is in onside, last minute of play. 2-1 Cy-Woods. Can they hold on? House, right wing circle, shoots high off the glass. To the point, Dufresne down in the corner. Looking for a centering pass. The pass is picked off, and the puck is cleared to the neutral zone with 35 seconds to go. Here's a shot from the blue line, and Wright kicks it away. He has to retreat. to the far boards. The puck still in the Spartan zone. A turnover. Munoz lifts it off. It's backhanded in. He scores. And that will propel Cy-Woods to the Justice Cup final.
That was a great effort by Seven Lakes. Big time pressure. And it's hard to hold in there. And Munoz just kind of pitchforked it in there with the capper, Mike, and what a period.
Cy-Woods get the empty net goal. Munoz at 12:38, his 15th goal of the season and his second of the playoffs after scoring yesterday in the win over PFC. 18 seconds to go. Seven Lakes, the top team in all the ISHL in the regular season, will see their season end in the Justice Cup semifinals. Final 5 seconds of this semifinal. There it is. Cy-Woods to the Justice Cup final. They knock off the league's best Seven Lakes Spartans by a final score of 3-1.
What a game. Cy-Woods came to play. I played Seven Lakes maybe to that third period, and what goaltending by Apollich. Just absolutely perfection.
Gave up a goal in the first period to Daniel Dufresne, but closed the door the rest of the way, including some big time stops late in the third period. Seven Lakes had the empty, had the goaltender pulled. Teams will meet at center ice for the handshakes. Seven Lakes' season ends in the Justice Cup semifinals with a 3-1 loss. They were the league's best team in the regular season. But the third time was the charm for the Wildcats, and they'll get a chance to rest, come back for the 7 p.m. final.
And that extra rest, big time help. Upset on paper, but Cy-Woods won their division, came in here, very deep team, great pressure the entire game, outshot Seven Lakes, and the goaltending, excellent.
Coming up next, it'll be the second semifinal of our coverage today. Second of three games from the Sugarland Ice and Sports Center as the Ridge Point Panthers get set to square off against the Memorial West Whalers for the third time. Make it the fourth time this season. For David Feliciano, I'm Michael Silver. Stay tuned. Our second semifinal comes your way at approximately 4:15 here on LSN Sports. So don't go anywhere. We'll be back soon. Until then, so long.